fire.
I command them to the abyss. Say, God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
You are wonderful.
You are wonderful.
You are wonderful.
You are glorious.
You are glorious.
You are glorious.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
You are God of Abraham.
You are God of Abraham.
You are God of Abraham.
God of Isaac.
God of Isaac.
God of Jacob.
God of Jacob.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I adore you.
I adore you.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are the Alpha.
You are the Alpha.
The Omega.
The Omega.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings.
The Lords of Lords.
The Lord of Lords.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Counselor.
Counselor.
Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I worship you.
The wonderful Holy Ghost.
Wonderful Holy Ghost.
Wonderful Holy Ghost.
I surrender to you.
I surrender to you.
I surrender to you.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I adore you.
I adore you.
I adore you.
I open my heart.
I open my heart.
I open my heart.
Teach me your word.
Teach me your word.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me.
Reveal to me.
Reveal to me.
Your divine revelations.
Your divine revelations.
Your divine revelations.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, Jesus said that there I am in their midst. And also tonight, Jesus Christ is here, the Holy Ghost is here, God Almighty is here. We are in the presence of God and we'll have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
We learned in Zimbabwe.
You are Alpha and Omega.
Sing.
We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised.
Sing it again. Alpha and Omega.
You are Alpha.
Tonight we will have a privilege to go through the word of God together and the word of testimony tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
Our testimony reads as follows. Hail from itching in the body. There is a lady who called for prayer from Swaziland. She had a terrible headache. Also had pain in between her breasts. Her body would become itchy and swells. When she scratches the itching out, her body will become itchy and swells when she scratches the itching away. Her arm was two times its size because of the swelling. She has been suffering from these things for 6 months. She went to hospital. They tried treating her for allergy, but it did not work. She also tried traditional medicine, but it didn't work. This itching would normally start at 12 midnight. She was also not having peace at work as she was constantly fighting with her boss. Pastor Robert prayed for her over the phone. She felt heat in the stomach during the prayer. She felt that itching and she felt like needles were piercing all over her body and felt dizzy, but later disappeared. The headache disappeared and was free from all pains. Glory to God, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12, and then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night, and we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight we will get the word of God from the book of Luke chapter 3 from verse 21 NIV. It reads as follows. When all the people were being baptized, Jesus was baptized too. And as he was praying, heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended on him in bodily form, like a dove, and a voice came from heaven. You are my son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing during those days, and at the end of them he was hungry. The devil said to him, if you are the Son of God, tell the stone to become bread. Jesus answered, it is written, man shall not live on bread alone. The devil led him up to a high place and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Also tonight we will have a privilege to go through the word of God together. Let us go through the word of God from the book of Psalm 37. Let us read from verse number 1. Do not fret because those who are evil or be envious of those who do wrong. The word of God is saying that, do not fret or envious of those who do wrong. You know, sometimes you may find somebody doing wrong, living wrongly, doing the wrong stuff. Don't be jealous. Maybe somebody's a thief, professional thief. And when that person is a professional thief, it seems as if things are going well with that person. Then the Bible says, do not be envious of those. As a child of God, do not be envious of those. Let that not be something that you feel like you wish to do it. You feel like maybe you are in the wrong place. if you are a child of God, filled of the Holy Ghost, living by the word of God, continue to do so. It must not be something that you feel somebody who is those who are in the world. Because sometimes you look at those who are in the world, it seems as if the things are going right. Sometimes you see that person who's in the world, not born again, changing cars, changing houses, posting also in the social media, as if things are well with their lives. The Bible says that, do not be envious.
Amen.
Look at their lives. That are they living rightly, or are they living wrongly? Are they evil? Are they righteous? If they are living, no evil life, and out of the wrongdoing, you must not be deceived by the posting of their lives.
Amen.
By the achievement because of the wrongdoings.
Amen.
You know, like sometimes you see somebody, it seems as if everything is going well. It's going well, but this person is a professional robber. It's a professional scammer. You as a child of God, don't go like, no, I think you are in the wrong way. And you want to copy those ones. You as a child, remain in the word.
Amen.
Remain in the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says that.
Amen.
In the book of Psalm 37, verse number 2, for they are like grass, they will soon wither. Like grass, they will soon die away. Their success are short-lived. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Their success are not forever.
Amen.
Their success are short-lived. Then as a child of God, you remain in the word.
Amen.
Remain faithful to God.
Amen.
Remain faithful to God. Amen. Don't be moved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't be moved by achievement out of the wrongdoing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Say fire. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Say, I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I am enjoying the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Then as a child of God, remain faithful to God.
Amen.
Remain faithful to the word.
Amen.
Let the word continue to be the standard of your life.
Amen.
Let the word of God, let it continue to be the standard of your life.
Amen.
Because the Bible says that they are like grass, they will soon wither.
Amen.
How many people do you know? Do you know that sometimes it seems as if things were going well out of their wrongdoing, out of their evilness? But when you look back today, practically so in your days, you can be able to count that, oh, it did not last.
Amen.
Let me tell you this, the word of God is prophetic.
Amen.
You know, the one who's saying this is God. It's not men who are saying this kind of stuff.
Amen.
It was not David who was saying these things. It was God saying this through David.
Amen.
And because it was God, whatever God has said and what God said will come to pass.
Amen.
Don't argue with it.
Amen. Amen.
If this is what God is saying, you believe it.
Amen.
Because either way, whether you believe it or not, that is it. It is it.
Amen.
And as a child of
God, Amen.
Do not be. Do not fret. Or be envious of those who are in wrongdoing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Verse number 3, the Bible says that trust in the Lord and do good.
Amen.
And dwell in the land and enjoy safe pasture.
Amen.
The Bible says that trust in the Lord. Continue to trust upon the Lord.
Amen.
Be the Lord's disciple. The one who is totable, teachable.
Amen.
The one who allowed the Lord to teach them and allowed to live in the Lord's means.
Amen.
If the word of God say that, live like this, live like that. If the word of God say that, do this, do it like that.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, trust in the Lord. Do good.
Amen.
Do be good.
Amen.
And this goodness, what the Bible is talking about, do good as per the Lord's word.
Amen.
Do good as per the Lord, word of God.
Amen.
Amen.
As you are doing so, child of God, you are not wasting your efforts.
Amen.
The Bible says that once you have done that, you will dwell in the land and you will enjoy safe pasture.
Amen.
When the word of God Amen. Is talking about safe pasture, is that kind of a pasture that nobody will ever lay claim of?
Amen.
It will be by doing of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a safe pasture Amen. That the enemy cannot come and steal, kill, and destroy.
Amen.
Because, Amen. Hey, this kind of pasture, it is what the Lord have blessed you with.
Amen.
That even when the enemy is trying to steal, kill, and destroy, even when the enemy is trying to attack you, the Lord will protect it.
Amen.
The Lord Amen. Will fight for you.
Amen.
But you know, those who are trying to attack. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those Amen. Who are trying, you know, to live their lives out of the presence of God, out of the guardians of God, and they're trying to live their life by their own wisdom and their understanding, and end up living an evil life, and end up building their life by building it wrong. You know, their things are not protected. When the enemy want to steal, kill, and destroy, can do so freely without any opposition.
Amen.
You know,
Amen.
They're like they're in the fast lane of life.
Amen.
How many people where it seems as if their life were going very well? Very well. But their success were short-lived. Because they were there. They have lived their life worldly, built their life by wrongdoing, and suddenly the enemy came and destroyed and took their lives.
Amen.
Some of the people who are talking about are the people. These are the people. Hey, these are the people who are in the public spectacle. Where you could see, oh, this one, it seems as if everything was going well. It was as if everything was perfect. But because they were not protected. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
They were not protected. They could lose everything in an instant, in a twinkle of an eye. They could lose their very own eyes. They lose their everything in a twinkle of an eye. Because they were not living by the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Living by the word of God, rightly so, it is an investment.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say fire, yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. Fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I am enjoying the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Then living by the word of God is an investment where you are sure of your success. You are sure of your prosperity.
Amen.
Then that's what the word of God is saying. Trust in the Lord. Continue to do good, child of God.
Amen.
Dwell in, and then you will dwell in the land and enjoy safe pasture.
Amen.
Amen.
You will enjoy safe pasture.
Amen.
And the Bible says that take delight in the Lord and He will give you the desires of your heart.
Amen.
Continue to enjoy the Lord.
Amen.
Continue to enjoy the Lord.
Amen.
Find yourself, find activities that are in the Lord.
Amen.
And enjoy the Lord.
Amen.
And part of doing it is when you are enjoying prayer.
Amen.
Enjoy prayer.
Amen.
Enjoy being in the presence of God.
Amen.
Enjoy doing the things of the Lord.
Amen.
As you are enjoying being in the presence of God, doing the activities of God, the Bible says that, hey, in His presence, He will give you what the desires of your heart.
Amen.
The desires of your heart that the enemy cannot lay claim of.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Stay in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Why are yourself this way? Why are yourself this way? Deal with your heart this way. Deal with your mind this way. That by fire, by fault, I delight in the Lord.
Amen.
I don't delight on the things of the world, but I delight in the things of God.
Amen.
Why are yourself? Refuse. The Bible says that resist the devil and the devil will do what? Will flee from you.
Amen.
Resist the devil. When the devil is trying to push you to enjoy the things of the world, because the things of the world are short-lived.
Amen.
The things of the devil are short-lived.
Amen.
Because actually the devil is a bad devil.
Amen.
The devil is a wicked devil.
Amen.
You know, the devil can give somebody seven colors rice. When he gives somebody seven colors rice, he know that inside, you must know that inside he has put heretics. As a child of God, you must know that, hey, you must delight in the Lord.
Amen.
Enjoy the Lord.
Amen.
Enjoy spending time in the presence of God.
Amen.
Enjoy doing the things of God.
Amen.
And the Bible says that when you have done so, He will give you the desires of your heart.
Amen.
He will take care of you.
Amen.
He will make sure that you have got a safe pasture.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Enjoy being in the Lord.
Amen.
When the enemy is trying to make, don't allow yourself to ever think that, hey, enjoyment is out there. That is the lie of the devil.
Amen.
A child of God's enjoyment must be in the Lord.
Amen.
When you have tamed yourself.
Amen.
Tamed yourself and you speak like David. David, who says that in the book of Psalm 23. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible said that in Psalm 23. He says that surely goodness, verse number 6, surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen.
So I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Then once you have dwelt in the house of the Lord forever, goodness and love, goodness and mercy will follow him.
Amen.
Because it's where he is in his glory, he's in his presence.
Amen.
And as a child of God, yours, ours, let it be dwelling in the presence of God.
Amen.
Let it be doing the activities of God.
Amen.
Let it be enjoying the things of God.
Amen.
And those who think they are wise, you know, those who are in the world, you know, they always want to make themselves clever, you know.
Amen.
And that is the lie of the devil. When the devil wants to destroy somebody, we lie to that person. It makes them to feel like they are clever. Even Eve felt like she was clever. When the devil was tempting Eve, she felt like she was clever. And she thought she had found her own snake and a wise decision. A new discovery out of the word of God. Out of God's instruction. God's instruction was clear, but the enemy made Eve as if to feel like she's wise. God have said this, but they have not told you this. God have said this, but there's this which is looks better. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then most of the time, the day that you begin to feel like you are wiser than the word of God, that's where the problem begins.
Amen.
That's where the mistakes begin.
Amen.
That's when stupidity begin.
Amen.
And that's where the distraction begin.
Amen.
It is the serpent, the enemy, who is trying to steal, kill and destroy.
Amen.
Because if you are not wise and stick to God's word, hey, that's when the enemy wants to take everything. Like what you have done to Adam and Eve. After when they thought they were clever and go out of God's word and took the advice of the enemy, he took everything. That's what the Bible will say, that was the fall of man. That was one of the biggest mistakes ever man has ever made. Not to listen to God. Many people today are in big trouble. The enemy has finished them. The enemy has finished them because, first of all, he enticed them and make them feel that they were clever and they did not listen to God's word and listen to the devil. But today they are nothing.
Amen.
Some they are dead because of that. Some they are in hospital. Some they are in the deathbed. Some they are in big trouble because they've listened to the devil. Then when you have that idea, as a child of God, wisen up. check, is it aligned to God's word? What does God say about this? If it does not align to God's word, the Bible said that resist the devil and the devil will flee from you.
Amen.
When the devil has flee from you, then you would have defeated the devil. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Otherwise, when the devil want to destroy you, hallelujah.
Amen.
He will make you feel like, hey, here you are very wise. He will make you feel like you are even wiser than God.
Amen.
He will even make you feel like, you know, what is prayer? You think, what is prayer? What is the service? It is as if all those times that you are spending time in the presence of God, you are wasting your time. It is as if He was giving you a better activity. That you feel like, for the rest of those days which you are spending the time in the presence of, it's as if you are wasting your time. No, it's a trap.
Amen.
Even the rat, when it finds the rice with seven colors, it feels like, for all this time, why could I not be finding this rice? And when is it eating that rice? Is not even aware that this is a death trap.
Amen.
It is later the same thing with sin. Sin does not appear to be dangerous. It appears to be sweet.
Amen.
It is only later when somebody is beginning to see what the devil has planned for them. What the devil has been planning for them. That's when they realize, the enemy's plan was to steal, kill, and destroy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you, as a child of God, trust in the Lord, hallelujah.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord, hallelujah.
Amen.
Let the word of God be the standard of your life.
Amen.
Let the word of God be the wisdom of your life.
Amen.
The word of God is God's wisdom.
Amen.
Let it be your best wisdom.
Amen.
Let it be your best advice.
Amen.
Amen.
Make sure that your life and your activity fits to God's word.
Amen.
And if they are saying you are wise, your wisdom must be fitting to God's word.
Amen.
If anything is out of the word of God, take it as if it's a foolishness.
Amen.
And say that I'm not the type to do this.
Amen.
I live by the word.
Amen.
I belong to the word.
Amen.
And when they show you somebody who is living a worldly life, and it seems as if they are prospering, you as a child of God say that is their foolishness.
Amen.
They will learn the hard way.
Amen.
I don't learn the hard way. I learn by the words.
Amen.
You must tell yourself that. I don't learn the hard way. I learn by the word.
Amen.
The word of God is my wisdom.
Amen.
The word of God is the standard of our life.
Amen.
Otherwise, if you don't do that, the enemy is a bad bastard.
Amen.
Wicked bastard.
Amen.
Whose plan only it is to steal, kill, and destroy. He have destroyed many. He have finished many. He has destroyed many, he has finished many, he wants to finish you too. I don't know who I'm talking to you. If it is not aligning to God's word, it is not wisdom, it's foolishness.
Amen.
Don't take that decision.
Amen.
If it does not allow to the word of God, don't do it.
Amen.
Stick to the word. Stick to the Lord.
Amen.
He is the best, better than any best.
Amen.
Tonight, I want us to go and pray. To repent and asking the Holy Ghost, help me to align the whole of my life to the word. Help me to align my everything to the word. Help me to trust upon the Lord wholly.
Amen.
Mantra frakito pakida baha. Paramantokatapahakitorokoshe. Lantarakasheke tere baba baba baba. Mandarabasa doroboshla daraba. Mandalabason daraba yeteleba. Of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Surely goodness and love shall follow me all the days of my life. And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Say, Lord Jesus Christ, you are my Lord. You are my Savior. Wash me with your blood. Forgive me my sins. Bless me today. Protect me from today with your power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Tomorrow is Friday. We are praying, we are fasting. As we are praying and we are fasting, and so tomorrow we have got our biggest prayer and fasting for the week. Let us continue to do so. And I want to say to you, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day, and afternoon and night.
Amen. Bye bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.